For me, no, I always had Muslim friends since the very beginning, so this was normal for me. I always, yeah, had friends who, you know, went out to pray at times, so yeah, no problem for me.
My entire social circle before I became Muslim was, they were essentially all non-Muslim. So initially, yeah, very tough. Like, do you show that you have now become a Muslim by praying, you know, or like stop eating halal? Then like, you, after you do that, then like there comes of the barrage of questions. Oh, you know, what can you do, what can you not do now, and everything, right? So initially, yeah, I guess like it gets easier when you learn more and you start to feel that you want to be Muslim. Then you start to identify with being a Muslim, and that is your identity now. Then you start caring less because you are more focused on doing the right things. Yeah.
When it comes to maybe Chinese friends, it will be difficult because they'll be like, oh, I want to eat. You want to eat this one? I'm like, sorry, I don't know halal. I cannot eat.
I mean, like, I think I don't think this has anything to do with the fact that I'm Chinese. I think as a Muslim, if I were to go out with my friends who are not Muslim, right, then like I would need to pray and they wouldn't be praying, you know. So I would say that like the difficulties might come where, you know, when we want to make plans, you know, and I have to factor in a place to pray, a time to pray, places that we want to eat, you know.
I honestly, right, when I'm in SMU, I think the minorities there, like us as Muslims, are very few of us. So sometimes I have to interact with a lot of, you know, non-Muslims there. And sometimes when I do projects with them, I have to go for lunch and dinner, and sometimes I have to separate from them. So it is sometimes very hard because I don't want to feel obliged to make sure that they have to eat halal food just because I'm there.